of the Baltimore Ravens, C.J. Mosley. Welcome back to Tuscaloosa. I hope you're doing well.
Yes, sir. I'm doing well. How about you?
Good, good. So walk us through the last month. What's it been like for you?
Man, it's been nonstop. It seems like yesterday I was just getting done with our Sugar Bowl, and now I'm just finishing minicamp as a Baltimore Ravens. So, I mean, I can say I'm blessed. I'm happy to be in the situation that I'm in.
CJ, what are you going to do? Okay, because this is probably the first time that you're going to be able to relax. What are you going to do until you get ready to start training camp, about a month away?
Really. Then they always say your rookie year is the longest. So after, like, I'm done today, but next week I go to my rookie symposium, and after that I'm finally free. So they give me maybe 2 weeks and a half before we report right back to training camp. So I can't take too much time off, because I got to make sure I'm in shape and ready to go for training camp.
Absolutely. Can you talk about the pressure? Because, you know, you look at the University of Alabama. We had Ozzie Newsom on last week. And, you know, that prestigious position, a linebacker at the Baltimore Ravens, means something when you're counted on to be that position.
Yeah, I mean, it's an honor for me to be in a situation. You know, came from a humble family, had a lot of blessings come my way, and I blessed a lot of people through what I've done. So I can say that going to Alabama for 4 years under Nick Saban and Coach Smart and everybody there that helped out with the organization, they really helped me out a lot, because Alabama really is a miniature NFL team. A lot of stuff you do here at Baltimore, you did the same thing or even more at Alabama. So, I mean, I'm in a great position. I'm trying to do my best to make the best of my situation with it.
All right, so what's the conversations with Ozzie been like? Obviously, he was an all-time great here, and we featured him last week to talk about you and some of the other Alabama guys. But what's those conversations been like?
Just make sure that I'm doing good, you know, transition the right way, make sure I'm getting everything that I'm supposed to get. And when I see him, you know, I'm pretty busy most of the day, so it's a quick, hey, how you doing? But, like, before I got football and practice started, it's just making sure that I'm adjusting things the right way. Just pretty much looking out for another alumni.
CJ, growing up in the state, committing to play at the football at the University of Alabama, spending time here in Tuscaloosa, winning the championships that you were able to accomplish, do you ever look back and have to pinch yourself on what you were able to accomplish here in Tuscaloosa?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes I see pictures of me holding up the trophy, and sometimes I wish I just would have cherished the moment a little bit more. You know, with Coach Saban, it's all about starting the next process. And as you get older and more mature as an Alabama football player, you know, after you win, as you had a success that 1 year, you're ready to have the next year. So after my junior year, I was just ready to get back on the field and try to win another one. So, I mean, just looking back at pictures and looking at pictures from my freshman year, just realize how fast time goes by. So you got to make sure you cherish your moment, because you never know how many you're going to get or when the last one's going to be.
CJ, if I said this to you, CJ Mosley is one of the, looking at statistically speaking, one of the all-time best linebackers that ever played that wore a crimson jersey. How would you handle that?
I don't know. You know, most people know I'm not a guy to brag or talk a lot. Try to stay humble and soft-spoken, so I'll probably just laugh and just say thank you. But, I mean, it just shows that just when you buy into the system, as you hear Coach say all the time, if you buy into the system, you're going to be successful. So, I mean, I just did my job, really. So, whatever they needed me, whatever they wanted me, I was there to do it.
CJ, give some credit to those other teammates that you played with. I want you to point one guy, the guys that you went up against practice or a game, or you watched their performance. Since you arrived here in Tuscaloosa, who's the best player that you played with here in T-Town?
Are you talking about offense or defense?
No, either one. Either one. Best player. The one guy that just shocked you the way that he played.
On defense, I'm going to go with Mark Barron. You know, a lot of players are going to say the same thing. That's been there. A player that's there now. When it came to Mark Barron, he was 100% all the time. And if people know him, he really don't talk a lot. So when he did, everybody listened. Coach Saban, all the way down to the scouting players. So he was a well-respected player my 2 years playing with him. So I try to mentor my game like him some too.
Trey DePriest is going to be asked to fill that role that C.J. Mosley had for the last couple of years. Have you had talks about filling that role and sort of the leadership responsibilities on that defensive side of the ball?
Yeah, people try to, like, simulate, you know, me being next Ray Lewis, filling the gap that he did, and my response to all of them was, that's not what I'm here to do. That's why they didn't draft me. Of course, I'm going to make plays and be a leader on the team, but I can only be me, so I'm going to do what I have to do to make plays, because there's never going to be another 52 for this football team, so I was just going to do the best to be the next 57.
So that's what you would tell Trey DePriest to try to fill C.J. Mosley's shoes as well and at that linebacker position?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, man has two different players. He's a bigger player, and he covers just like I do. So I give him ups on being able to be a first and second down player better than I was. He started on our base defense his sophomore year and played his freshman year. So I mean, he's going to be a great player. And I told him he's going to be in the same situation I was coming from my junior year to my senior year. Then when I'm on the field, I can dime or the sub plays, but he's in our regular. That's just how it was my junior year when Nico and Trey was in the game. So me and him just switching roles. So I mean, he just gotta. I understand how big shoes feel, but you're gonna have to prove that he's worth being an every down player. Because the more down you stay on, the higher you're gonna be in the draft. And I believe in him. I know he's gonna do what he has to do to control that defense.
What are you expecting from Alabama in 71 days,
sir?
What are you expecting from Alabama in 71 days? As far as the team?
A win. I mean, come out strong like they always do. We always, so say, we're always talking about starting fast and finishing strong and going from summer training into going into fall camp is all about starting fast and finishing strong. That first game, we have to, whoever can they play, they better blow them out. They don't want to start like we did this past year. Our offense, defense, struggling. So you just got to go out and go at it because I'm going to be a roll tide 100%.
Absolutely, and I'm sure you'll be following it. I want to go back to the Nick Saban process because when you arrived here, you were a super player. You had God-given ability, no doubt about it. But can you talk about how Alabama sort of developed you as a player going through this Nick Saban process? And I mean, you were drafted in the first round and sort of a dream come true. But talk about Alabama Nick Saban's role in development of C.J. Mosley.
Well, the first thing that's going to change as far as a young 18, 17, 19-year-old going into that system, going to Alabama, is you're going to have to be a man. You're going to have to mature real fast. You have to handle your time well. You have to go to class. You're going to have to do the right thing. So if you come from a hard background or a humble background, it doesn't matter. Everybody will have to go through that same process because one day that freshman year, you're going to have to realize the things that you probably can get away with during the summer, when it's not a must class, not a must pressure as far as being a football player. It's all going to change, and you have to make plays and have to step up and be a player and pretty much go to Alabama, what you're trying to do is play football, get an education. So the first thing first, the young guys have to step up and be a man real early. Because Coach Saban's gone. Just one thing he told me, one thing I always remember, my freshman year, after I messed up a few times, I kind of gave that excuse to ask. I haven't been here this long, so I don't know that much. And thing he told me, I'm a coach like you've been here 4 years. So no matter what, Mark Barron, or with me messing on the play, he's gonna coach you the same way. So he's not gonna spare nothing less if you're on the field.
Did you ever feel the pressure of winning in Alabama? Because I look at 11-2, and for most teams, that's a successful season. 11-2, it is a successful season. But where you guys put this program, it's almost national championship or bust. Did you ever feel the pressure of trying to win a national championship every single year?
I mean, it's your goal and your standard set that high, it's not really pressure to win it. It's pressure to do the things the right way to help you win, put you in that position to win. So that's really all the process is. When you commit to Alabama, when you go to Alabama, that's pretty much why you go there, because you know that team has a potential chance of going to the national championship every year. And you have the chance to develop around some great players and great coaches, be a great player yourself, and also get a great education. So that was my main thing, to going to Alabama. So knowing that, it was all about me buying into the process and doing the right things right, not really hoping we win all these games, because we pick it one game at a time, man. And in the SEC, you have to, because you overlook one team, that's when you get punched in the mouth.
CJ, Nick Saban recently got a huge contract, $7 million a year. As a guy that played for him, you know Nick Saban as well as anybody. What would you pay Nick Saban if you were the athletic director at Alabama?
What would I pay him?
What would you pay him a year to coach football?
I'll pay whatever he needs. Keep him at Alabama, because knowing him, he's a humble guy. You know, he's going to coach you hard. He's going to do what he has to do to make the right decision. But at the end of the day, for him, it's not even about the money. It's about him bringing in those young guys and developing them into grown men like he did with like me and the past players that I played with. It's almost half the defense I played with, most of them in the NFL or having some kind of success in the business or whatever they graduated in. So, because that was all about the statistics of his players going to the NFL, being successful young men, not really just getting the man and getting them out.